Hey guys, what's going on? Welcome back for a brand new reaction video. And today we're checking out
Bring Me the Horizon.
Die for You. It's not even their latest track anymore.
I know. Wait, what is the newest one?
Yeah, right? That's how long we waited to do this video. Bring Me the Horizon. I don't know what the new one is. Didn't they just do one like a couple days ago with Tom Morello? There it is right there. Tom Morello, Let's Get the Party Started, featuring Bring Me the Horizon. Oh, so technically that's Tom.
Oh, it's his song featuring them.
Yeah.
That's cool. That's an interesting collab that I never would have seen coming.
Although a lot of Ollie's collabs are like that.
Yeah, I love that about this band, actually. And they collab with people that I've never heard of, and then I'm like, wow, there's this new thing that I never would have known about otherwise. Like the twins from the last record.
The Nova Twins.
Nova Twins, yeah.
That's my favorite song by this band,
mm-hmm.
One by One. I got asked that recently. Is One by One still your favorite song? I was like, yeah, but I haven't listened to Die for You yet. So we'll see.
This could replace it. That's interesting that you know right off the bat what your favorite Bring Me song is.
Yeah.
I don't know that I have one.
No?
I don't know.
And favorite's like such a weird concept.
It's like a very transient thing anyways.
Yeah. Like favorite implies like such permanence.
Because things can be your favorite for like a day.
Yeah. But at the moment, that's the one.
You know when people will ask you like those random questions, like if you're stranded on a desert island and you can only listen to one record or one band or one something.
Okay.
You know those questions?
Yes.
I would choose this as my band.
Bring Me the Horizon.
Yes, because they have like a really wide range of types of songs, and they also have a pretty big catalog at this point.
Yeah, I probably have to agree.
Just because then it's like you could wake up one day and want to listen to metal, or you could want to listen to something a little lighter, a little chiller.
Yeah, totally.
A little more out there.
Yeah, I don't listen to a ton of metal, so that makes total sense. Because sometimes I do want to listen to metal.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sometimes it just depends on how you're feeling. And like their early stuff is what I grew up with. And like I'm almost never tired of listening to what I grew up listening to. I'm inexhaustible.
Really?
Like Bullet for My Valentine, Avenged Sevenfold, like Old Motionless. Like I can just listen to all that stuff. Linkin Park.
Oh.
On repeat like for eternity and probably never tire of it.
Yeah, that's true actually.
Right? Old Slipknot.
The first two records that got me into music was No Pads, No Helmets, Just Balls by Simple Plan and The Young and the Hopeless.
Yes. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
That's the one.
That. And those two records, if you come out to my Monday streams, Clubhouse Drums, where I play drums on Twitch, you know that I play those songs all the time.
I know when you're playing them, even if I'm not watching the stream. Like, I just know the drums.
Yeah.
Yeah.
For real. That's the case with that. But then, like, as you get older, you'll go through phases and then you won't want to listen to something. You can get exhausted later.
Yeah. Like, something I listened to a year ago on repeat, I'm like, now, like, oh, I'm so sick of it.
Yeah. Totally.
Yeah.
Totally. I've done that with Bring Me the Horizon.
Yeah. Totally, totally. Actually. Yeah. When Ammo came out, I feel like.
Yeah.
Remember we were listening to Ammo, like, back to front, like, a bunch?
Oh, constantly and then never again. Yeah. It was, like, constant. And then one day, it just stopped. Oh, and then the other one I did that with was Motionless and White's record, Disguise.
Yes. Yes.
That was every single day.
Oh my God. That was like so much.
Do you guys at home probably can relate to this too. When a new record comes out and you find like the sweet spot in the record, like there's like one point where like you can start it here, like maybe it's song six and song six will be okay, but it's like not bad. But you know that seven and eight are just going to blow your mind. Nine's okay. And then 10, another banger, 11, another banger. And then you can just start from that point again because the first three before that, have you ever had that before?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. Yeah. Disguise was like that for me where I would start later in the record. There was a few on the top like Code and whatever, but I wanted to hear Holding On to Smoke and Another Life.
Those are your two faves, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ammo was like that with me too. After a while.
There are some songs on Ammo that I can skip and some that I prefer to listen to. Like once you get like Sugar, Honey, Ice, and Tea, I'm pretty sure is farther down.
Yeah.
And then like once I get into that area, I'm like, oh, so good.
What's a record that comes to mind right away that like you don't even do that with? You start at the very beginning and you go to the very end. And
there's Hybrid not a Theory. Single one.
Hybrid
by
Theory.
By Linkin Park.
Yeah. Yeah. That's about right.
Yeah.
A few of the Parkway Drive records I felt that about.
Hmm.
Yo, Sepeternal. Totally.
Totally, yeah.
Totally.
That's a good one.
That's the Spirit, I could probably say that about.
Ooh. Old Lindsay would say Infest, Papa Roach.
Infest, Papa Roach.
Loved all those songs.
Yeah, it's interesting what a record can do for you.
Mm-hmm.
So with all that in mind, let's check out where Bring Me the Horizon currently is with what they're putting out. But just before we do, huge shout out to Styx, Cade, Albin, Stefan, Ted, Sean, Ethan, Julian, Clay, Susan, Kevin, and Tim for being our patrons and requesting songs like this one for us to check out with all of you. If you want to join our Patreon so you can request songs for us to check out in the future here on the channel, you can find a Patreon link in the description below. Let's get into it. That's a door?
Yeah, I think that's a door.
With like flies and blood and...
Yeah. Oh, it's probably like a nightclub. Like an underground nightclub. Business.
Oh, snap.
Whoa, she kind of looks like Trinity from Matrix.
Це приватна вечірка.
Я до Фрама. Він мене чекає.
Sorry, guys. I'm a slow reader. I'm gonna go back. I'm here to see Alfgram.
Alfgram?
Okay.
Yeah. Are they speaking Russian?
Yeah, it sounds Russian. Ooh.
Love that razor blade earring.
You know that I died for, I cried for, you know that I died for you. You know that I grieve for, I bleed for, you know that I grieve for you. Let me see my halo, even though it's painful, I'm prepared to lose. You know that I died for. Keep holding my breath for America. Hoping that hole in my heart would heal somehow. Feeling so fucking close to the edge right now. You know you're everything I hate. I could escape, but you know I would die for you. You know that I'd die for, I'd cry for, you know that I'd die for you. You know that I'd breathe for, I'd live for, you know that I'd breathe for you. Let me see my halo, even though it's painful, I'm prepared to lose. You know that I'd die for, I'd cry for, you know that I'd die for you.
Oh, what? It's getting a little pop punk now.
Oh shit.
This isn't love. This is a car crash. This isn't love. This is a bloodbath. This isn't love. This is a sentence. It's a bullet in the head. This isn't love. This is a car crash. This isn't love. This is a bloodbath.
Okay. Gosh. Chef's kiss. Double chef's kiss. That was so good. It was so good. Obviously, right? You thought it was good?
Yeah. Okay. Oh my God.
Cool. Wow. Dude, he said love is a bloodbath, or this isn't love, it's a bloodbath. And then it was a literal bloodbath. And the pants and jacket on Ollie fit so perfectly. Did you notice?
I did, actually.
It was like the pants hit at the perfect spot and the jacket hit at the perfect spot. And they were the perfect like width for his legs. And the hem was like exactly where it should have been. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I'm not afraid to admit I was checking that out for sure.
Nothing in his outfit was like a millimeter off.
No.
It was so perfect.
He looked great. The band looked great.
Yep, yep.
It looked sick. That was so cool.
That was so cool.
I didn't expect... Dude... You're right, man. This is a desert island band.
Yeah, see, they have so much. You just never know. You never know what's going to happen.
That was That was so good.
Yeah, you never know what you're going
to
get.
Holy shit, my eyes are running. I might have a new favorite.
Oh my gosh, yeah? Yeah. This totally has you written all over it, too.
Yeah.
Like the popular chorus, I feel like really, really vibes with you.
Yeah, die for you. What did that make you feel?
What did it make me feel? It actually just made me feel happy.
I was thinking about you the whole time.
Really?
Yeah.
Why?
Because you're someone in my life I'd die for.
Me too, obviously. I'd die for you as well.
Yeah. It's important to have those people.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. I don't know if that was the song was about, but that's what I was thinking of.
Yeah.
All right. Let's see what, let's see what's going on.
Song.
Let's check it out. Let's check it out.
You know that I die for, I cry for. You know that I die for you. You know that I breathe for, I bleed for. You know that I breathe for you. Let me see my halo, even though it's painful. I'm prepared to lose. You know that I die for. You're pulling my breath for a miracle. Hoping the hole in my heart would have healed somehow. Feeling so fucking close to the edge right now. You know you're everything I hate. Wish I could escape, but you know I would die for you.
Ooh, dude, look, read lower down. We've got like a Take Back Sunday vibes here. Hang on. Because the truth of it, you could slit my wrist and I'd write your name in a heart with the hemorrhage. I was thinking this the other day, that Taking Back Sunday lyric. This like, the truth is, you could slit my throat and with my one last gasping breath, I'd apologize for bleeding on your shirt. Totally reminds me of that.
Yeah, that's definitely on the same sort of wavelength. Sort of,
yeah, same sort of vibe.
There was a couple times I thought it was going to go heavy and it didn't. It went into like a guitar solo in the bridge there.
The guitar solo caught me so off guard. Yeah. That is so unusual. I was like, what? Guitar solo?
This is just that band that time and time again pushes every boundary. They don't exist inside of lines. Like, cool. Okay, I don't really have anything else to add. Do you?
No, not really.
Desert Island Band.
Yeah.
So that was Bring the Horizons, Die for You. I hope you guys enjoyed. Thanks again to the patrons for supporting this channel and our content and making what we do possible. Styx, Cade, Albin, Stefan, Ted, Sean, Ethan, Julian, Clay, Susan, Kevin, Tim. Thank you guys for being a patron. And we will see you all very soon with something new.